Hello, this is Alex Loy from the technical marketing team at Dell Technologies. In this video, we will present the different topology and networking options for our Dell integrated system for Microsoft Azure Stack HCI offering. There are three deployment options for Dell integrated system for Microsoft Azure Stack HCI: single node clusters, switchless storage clusters, and scalable clusters. Single node clusters are the simplest and easiest way to set up Azure Stack HCI. In most cases, they have very light network requirements, starting as low as only 2 network port connections for management and VM traffic. Then we have switchless storage clusters with 2, 3, or 4 node cluster sizes and always configured with non-converged topology. In non-converged scenarios, the network traffic is split in two, where one or more adapters are used for management and VM traffic, and one or more other adapters are used for the RDMA storage traffic. Scalable clusters have both options: non-converged, as we have just described, and converged, where management, VM, and storage traffic all share the same network adapters. Single node clusters are a great fit for remote, edge, or branch projects because they're very sensitive to cost and space requirements. They support the same workloads as multi-node Azure Stack HCI clusters and behave similarly, although we must remember that in these scenarios, the fault domain is the server itself. To learn more about the considerations of using Azure Stack HCI on a single server, see this article. You can deploy a switchless storage configuration to avoid an additional investment in top-of-rack switches, or as a way not to consume existing switch ports for storage communications. The 2, 3, or 4 node full mesh interconnect requires direct network cable connections between every node of the cluster. For redundancy and performance purposes, we recommend dual-link direct network connections between every node of the cluster. For 2-node clusters, dual-link full-mesh switchless interconnect is mandatory. For 3- and 4-node clusters, either single-link or dual-link full-mesh storage network topologies are permitted. Bear in mind that single-link full-mesh topologies rely on the management network for storage and live migration redundancy purposes. The management network is also shared with VM traffic. During failure scenarios and high-throughput network load, contention between these three traffic types can degrade the cluster. For this reason, Dell recommends a dual-link full-mesh network interconnect for high-performance storage configurations and workloads. These sample diagrams are right out of our switchless deployment guide available on the Dell Technologies Info Hub. This guide indicates how many PCIe slots are available in the different AX nodes and how many adapters are required for the different switchless storage configurations. For example, configuring a dual-link full-mesh switchless storage topology for a 4-node cluster requires 3 adapters. It is very important to take cluster size into account before deploying a full-mesh switchless storage cluster. Remember that expanding an existing switchless storage topology is not supported. A redeployment is necessary to perform such an expansion, or if attempting to go from a single link to a dual link full mesh design. Scalable cluster configurations can start as small as 2 nodes and easily expand to the maximum cluster size of 16 nodes at 1 node or more increments. Top-of-rack switches are mandatory in these scenarios to meet the storage port count requirements and guarantee future cluster growth. Here are the high-level configurations and topologies discussed in the end-to-end deployment guide with scalable networking. In a fully converged network topology, all storage ports from the server are connected to the same network fabric. Within the host OS, the NIC ports are used for both storage, plus, VM, and management traffic. In non-converged network configurations, the storage traffic is separated from the VM and management traffic using dedicated storage network adapters. We tend to recommend the non-converged topology because it's easier to troubleshoot, and you can avoid potential contention between LAN and SAN. To get more details for each of these topologies, just follow the link to the end-to-end deployment guide with Scalable Networking on the Info Hub. To conclude, here are the latest Dell PowerSwitch network switches that are tested and validated to work with our AX nodes. 10 gigabit is a minimum requirement for RDMA storage traffic, but we strongly recommend going with 25 gigabit because the cost per port is about the same. Plus, it provides extra future usability. Be sure to allow for enough ports when considering how your cluster will scale into the future. These switches are fully supported as part of the Azure Stack HCI architecture with Dell Pro Support Plus. Dell provides sample network switch configuration files for the different networking topologies discussed in the previous slides. To get access to them, just follow this link to the Info Hub and select the document that pertains to your environment. That wraps up this summary of the different topology and networking options for our Dell integrated system for Microsoft Azure Stack HCI offering. Thanks for watching.